truly the Lord is here. Yes. And I was standing along the lines of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And in the book of Mark, you can find this, 12 through 15, Matthew 4, 1 through 11, Luke 1 through 13. And this was after Jesus' baptism by John, and before Jesus called his disciples. In the 12th verse, immediately the Spirit drove him into the wilderness. Amen. And he was there in the wilderness 40 days, tempted of Satan, and was with wild beasts in the field, brothers and sisters. And the angels ministered unto him. And just a little different perspective of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes God leads us into areas where we may be tested, tried, to see whether we will be faithful, amen, unto him. The scriptures say God don't tempt a man, but he tests your faith to see whether you will hold your line. And as a result of testing, the Bible says that he always makes a way of escape. Amen. However enticed or strong that temptation is, God has a doorway out in which we can escape. Amen. And so Jesus is an example of that. Amen. Being the Son of God and being allowing himself to go in the wilderness. And by the way, the wilderness is where Jesus picked up when the children of Israel failed in the wilderness. Amen. And God sent them around. It was like a couple of days' journey from where they were in Egypt to the promised land. But God made them wander around for 40 years. Amen. In the desert. Because to test them. And to get rid of some of the things that they had in their hearts. So God, Jesus picks up that challenge where God left off his Old Testament. That's where the wilderness experience comes from. When they failed, Jesus gave victory.
Yes.
He was our victor. Amen. He took up the battles on our behalf. Amen. In any manner of temptation, and truly, they failed at wandering in the wilderness. So Jesus came to conquer, amen, where they failed. He challenged the devil through the Holy Spirit, challenged the devil, amen, in the wilderness, so that his people ultimately will be justified. And 14th verse says, now after that John was put in prison, Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God. Amen. And there's all kinds of messages out here today. The message of prosperity. Amen. People are putting a rabbit tail in their pockets. They are seeing soothsayers. They're going to readers. Amen. They're moving Ouija boards around, amen, and all kinds of things they think that will bring them prosperity, amen. But the scripture, amen, says that God is against that, amen. And Jesus came with one message, amen, and that message was of the kingdom of God. And Paul said, if any man preach any other gospel, even the angels which are in heaven, let it be accursed. Amen. And so we only have one gospel to look forward to, man. And when Jesus came, they didn't recognize him. And Jesus said unto them, he said, you read the scriptures. You study the scriptures. But the scriptures testify of me. Amen. So, in all your studying, you missed something. Amen. You missed the most important lesson of the Bible. And that is the coming of Jesus. Amen. So, in the Old Testament, they look forward, amen, 2,000 years to the coming of Jesus. And in the New Testament, amen, they look back 2,000 years for the coming of Jesus. He's been here, amen, and showed up on the scene as the word of God had promised. Amen. And the time is fulfilled, the scripture said. Jesus said, time. Amen. As far as salvation was concerned, because they kept prophesying his coming. And when he came, amen, that he was an example, an emblem of the New Testament. The change that would take place between the Old Testament and the New Testament. Amen. And Jesus said, amen, in the New Testament, I know that you have been told that there was eye for an eye. And that's what the law was in the Old Testament. Amen. But Jesus said, I say. And when he said, I say, amen, this, I'm saying this, he qualified his statement. I know what the Bible said in the Old Testament. Of what God told you, gave this to you in the Old Testament. And Jesus said, but I said in the New Testament, amen, that we're not, amen, to hate our brothers. We're not to gouge his eye, amen. But we are to love him, amen, even as our brother, even as ourselves. And that was the challenge. Jesus changed it. Why? Because he was God in the flesh. And he had the power, amen, to change, amen, what the Father had given. Jesus said, I am equal to God. Amen. And so they crucified him because he made that claim. Now you said you're God. And to them that was blasphemy. You're cursing. Amen. But Jesus said unto him, his answer was, I am, amen, in the 8th chapter, I believe, of John. Jesus said, I am, amen, God. I am equal with God. And so they killed him for that reason. And so I'm about to sit down. But I wanted to say, the time is fulfilled, the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. Amen. And the gospel simply meant that Jesus, the Son of God, amen, was coming in to save his people. And in doing so, he was against the establishment that man had built on this earth. Because many of the things that man orchestrated did not define the kingdom of God. And we know that in the end, in the kingdom, Jesus will have the last word.